As I told you before, I will present you the paper Composite Scaffolds with Inclusion of Magnetite Nanoparticles for Bone Tissue Engineering. I will begin with some theoretical aspects and the objectives of the paper. Then I will present the preparation of composite scaffolds, the method of characterization, the results and discussions, and finally conclusions and some perspectives. In the human body are found more than 200 bones with various dimensions and shapes, providing very important functions for the human body, such as movement and locomotion, protection of some vital organs, contain the microenvironments for adult hematopoiesis, store minerals, and regulate hormones. Moreover, bone has an amazing feature unique in the human body. It's a regenerative capacity, which allows it to heal without structural and functional impairment in case of some problems. This can be mainly attributed to the balance between osteoblast and osteoclast activity. Next slide, please. Unluckily, this ability doesn't apply for long-term healing approaches of large bone defects, such as the void obtained after the resection of bone tumors. In this case, the reconstruction of the damaged bone is very difficult and is a real challenge in clinical practice because the conventional treatment methods, autografts, metallic implants, have proved to be only satisfactory and not great. For more than two decades, bone tissue engineering has been used as an alternative technique. Actually, bone tissue engineering is based on scaffolds, cells, and the bioactive molecules, scaffolds being the main component. Mainly, the scaffolds are based on natural and synthetic polymers mixed or not with ceramics. Magnetite used an iron oxide used mainly for hyperthermia and for drug delivery has gained also attention for bone tissue engineering because some studies have shown that it can increase the number of osteoblasts. Concerning all these theoretical aspects, the objectives of the paper were the preparation and characterization of composite scaffolds based on biopolymers, calcium phosphate, and magnetite nanoparticles. For the preparation of the composite scaffolds, we have chosen biomimetic method because it was proven that it is not enough to mimic the composition of the natural bone. It is very important to mimic its nanostructure. The solution of three biopolymers, collagen, chitosan, hyaluronic sodium salt, magnetite nanoparticles have been mixed with calcium chloride, with calcium phosphate precursors, calcium chloride and monosodium phosphate, and the pH of the mixture has been adjusted to 7.2 using aqueous ammonia. After being intensively washed with distilled water, the final mixture has been freeze-dried for 24 hours, resulting composite scaffolds. Next, Asha, as can be seen in table one, we have obtained three different composite scaffolds with the same composition in terms of biopolymers, but different calcium phosphor theoretical ratio. Next, please. The obtained composite scaffolds have been characterized in terms of physicochemical features and in terms of their in vitro behavior. Next, please. I think you have pressed two times. Okay, thank you. FTIR delivers key data about molecular vibration within functional groups, resulting specific absorption bands in the spectra that can be associated with the composition. In our study, we have identified some functional groups that are presented in table two. All these functional groups are specific to the components of our scaffolds, the three biopolymers, calcium phosphates, and the magnetite nanoparticles. The nature of the components, back, please. The nature of the components in the inorganic layer has been studied with X-ray diffraction. And in table 3 can be seen the identified the calcium phosphate types. XRD actually confirms again the composition of our scaffolds. Next, please. Cross-sectional morphology of the scaffolds have been studied using scanning electron microscopy. As can be seen in figure 2, we have obtained scaffolds with a three-dimensional architecture, a porous structure with calcium phosphates and magnetite nanoparticles distributed within the polymeric matrix. This porous structure is very important because it influences lots of properties, such as mechanical properties, in vitro behavior, and so on. Next, please. The mechanical properties have been studied by axial compression assays with a texture analyzer device presented previously by Professor Verestiuc. And we have calculated the Young modulus according to Hooke's law. As can be seen in figure 3, the values obtained for our scaffolds can be framed to the range of the values of natural trabecular bone. Next, please. The retention of body fluids is very important for bone tissue engineering scaffolds. In our study, we have chosen a volumetric method and we have determined the retention degree. In figure 4 are presented the values of the retention degree for the three composite scaffolds. It can be said that we have obtained values higher than 600%. These values can be attributed to the hydrophilicity of the polymers and very important to the porosity of the scaffolds previously confirmed by SEM. In vitro degradation has been studied using an enzymatic mixture containing lysozyme, the enzyme that degrades in vivo chitosan, and collagenase, the enzyme that degrades in vivo collagen. The data obtained for in vitro degradation showed in figure 5 can be attributed to the retention degree because the high retention degree provides the scaffolds to penetrate within the composite scaffolds and provides and control degradation. Next, please. In vitro cytotoxicity has been studied in indirect contact with human osteosarcoma MG63 cell line using porous membrane-based inserts. The cell viability measured by MTT assay has been proved to be higher than 85%, meaning that the scaffolds are non-cytotoxic. Moreover, we have studied the cell morphology after 120 hours of indirect contact with scaffolds. It can be seen that the form of the cells and their spreading is similar in control and in the whales with cells containing scaffold helicoids. Next, please. In conclusion, we have obtained composite scaffolds based on biopolymers, calcium phosphate, and magnetite nanoparticles, biomimetic method. The FTIR and XRD confirm the composition of the scaffolds. The scaffolds have a porous structure confirmed by SEM, which strongly influenced retention of simulated body fluids and in vitro degradation. The mechanical evaluation of the scaffolds in terms of Young modulus is similar to the trabecular bone tissue. And finally, the cytotoxicity test, MTT assay and morphology analysis indicated a non-cytotoxic effect of bone cells. Next, please. In the future, we will continue this study by magnetic feature researches. Also, we will do drug loading and growth factor loading, and we'll study their delivery. And also, we want to do in vitro cytotoxicity of composite scaffold loaded with drugs and growth factors. And finally, in vivo studies, cytotoxicity, and finally, evolution of scaffolds' capacity to sustain bone regeneration. Thank you very much for your attention, and please, if you have questions.
Okay, thank you for a very nice presentation. Maybe if somebody has some questions. No questions. I see that is very interesting work, and of course, there is still place for bone regeneration too, and for other type of regeneration. And nanofield, of course, will bring probably and sure for sure will bring new scaffolds and maybe new technologies for regeneration of different tissues. Okay, thank you very much.